Hi, let us understand about copy, command and work directory option available as a part of Docker file. Whenever I am creating an image, there might be a need to copy a file or set of files into the image, and that should be available, and there should be some default program which should get started whenever I am starting a container from that particular image. So I am going to see the options how to copy files into the image so that the files will be available in the container that I am starting, as well as how to handle the work directory, in the sense any operation that I am doing, in which directory that particular operation should happen within that particular image, and what command should get executed by default whenever that container is getting started. That's what we are going to see in this particular lecture. Let's do a small demo. Let me go ahead and create a small directory. Let me get into the directory. And I'm going to create a Docker file. So the base image, I will be having it as from Alpine. And I wanted to copy a file from the host location where I'm going to do the build to the image. I can copy an individual file. In this case, I'm going to copy a file called filecopytest.txt into a folder copied file with the name filecopy.txt. Same time, I can use the wildcard as well. Here, I am going to start all the files starting with the word multiple and get that copied into the copied files. Within that, it's going to create a folder files and all the files will get copied within that. And I can copy an entire folder as well. So this is to demonstrate we can copy an individual file or we can use a wildcard or I can copy an entire folder as well. Now, whenever I am going to do any operation, I need to give the entire path. Instead, I can give a working directory so that all the operation that I'm going to do, it will happen against this specific directory. So after setting the work directory, I'm going to copy a file within a folder after work directory. That means within copied files folder, the another folder named after underscore work directory will get created and the file will get copied into that. Now I'm going to set the work directory back to the root location, and I'm going to execute a shell. So whenever I'm logging into this particular container created out of this particular image, it should execute a shell. So I'm going to use the verb cmd. Within the cmd, I can execute any script. Now let me save this particular Docker file and create a build out of it. Before doing the build, I need to create the required files. That is, I'm going to create a file called filecopytest.txt, a sample test file. So I will echo this particular content into this filecopytest.txt, and I will create a couple of files starting with the word multiple. So I'm going to create a file multiple underscore file 1.txt and multiple underscore file 2.txt. Then I was using a file called direct to workdir.txt. That file will also get created. And I was copying a folder named folder 1. So let me go ahead and create a folder. Let me get into the folder and create a sample file within it. So I'm creating a file with the name in underscore folder 1.txt. So I do have text files to test with and a folder to test with. And I have the Docker file in the name of demo underscore copy. Now I need to do the build using this file demo underscore copy. Let me trigger the build Docker image build. Let me tag this as demo underscore copy, add the tag 1.0, and the file where I do have the instruction is demo underscore copy, and it is in this current location. So it will start with Alpine and it is going to copy the files file copy.txt, and it is copying files starting with the wildcard multiple, and it is copying the folder. Then it is changing the work directory and it is copying the files after changing the work directory, and it's changing back the work directory and it is adding the layer to start with the shell script. Now the image got created. I can go ahead and check whether the image is available. Demo underscore copy. Yes, it is available. Let me go ahead and create a container. Docker container. Let me run in the interactive mode, and the container should get removed whenever I am exiting this specific container. And let me name the container as underscore demo underscore copy, and the image I wanted to use is demo underscore copy colon 1.o. So the container will get started should be double dash. The container should get started and the control should get logged into the shell available within the container. And this container is running with Alpine. And all the content that we requested to get copied should be available within the file system. So I can go ahead and check. Yes, copied file, copied folder, it is available. So within copied file, I do have the individual file, the file copy.txt that I wanted to copy. And within files, I try to copy the files with wildcard multiple. Yes, I do have. And after work directory, after setting the work directory, it was copying the files into this specific folder after underscore work dir. So that also got copied. Now I can go ahead and check the Docker file. That should give additional clarity. Let me come out of this shell and the container should get terminated automatically. So this is what we did. We started a container with Alpine image and we copied the files, the individual file as well as files with wildcard and a folder. Then we changed the work directory and within the work directory, copied files. It created the after underscore work dir and the file got copied. Then a quick summary, we had seen three verbs, that is copy, work directory and CMD. And one more point to remember, if I have multiple CMD options, the last one will be relevant to that particular container and the earlier commands will get ignored.